Hello everyone, so in this video, let us talk about the C problem from the education code forces round 163. Problem name arrow path. So let's read the problem statement first. You are given a grid consisting of two rows and n columns. Okay, the rows are numbered from 1 to 2 from top to bottom. You have two rows. Okay, I'll also draw it out so that it will become more easy to visualize. You have two rows like this and n columns. Like this. So number from 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on. And the rows are 1 and 2. Okay. The columns are from internal from left to right. Okay. Each cell in the grid consists of an arrow pointing either to the left or right. So each cell has an arrow either to the left or right, and no arrow points outside the grid. No arrow points outside the grid. Okay. There is a robot starting at the cell 1, 1. There is a robot at here. Every second, the following two operations or two actions happen one after another. Okay. What are the two operations? Firstly, the robot will move either left, right, top, or bottom. The robot have a first, like initial will. The robot can move left, top, left, right, bottom, whatever direction the robot wants. But the only thing is that it should not go out of the bound of the grid, and you cannot skip a move. Okay, you actually always have to do a first move to either go left, right, top, bottom, and it should not go out of bound. Then after going to a particular box, let's say you move here. Then it moves to the arrow that is placed in the current cell, the cell that it ends up to after it moves. So if it ends up to a certain cell, then whatever is the arrow in that particular cell, let's say the arrow is moving towards the right. So then the robot will move to the right. That compromises one complete action, like one complete step. One step has two actions. Okay. So you, that is one of one steps. Okay. Now your actual task is to determine that whether the robot will lead to the cell 2n, that is 2n, that is the last cell of the second row, whether the robot will be able to reach here. That's a complete thing that you have to find out. Okay, let's see one of the examples, so that always some examples is very grateful and very helpful to see as well here. Okay, let's take this. Let's say that you have an a grid of two rows and it has four, let's say four columns. This is, let's say, right, right, left, left. Then this is right, 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 and left. Okay. So if I can take another color. Okay. Let's just start from here. You first go, this is the example as well. You will also take that. You will first go left to the right. Once, like this is one action. You will go to the right. And then when whatever cell you lands upon, you will take the arrow of that and go to that. So you will go to this. Because this is going to the right, so you land to this. Which means that you will first go from 1, 1, 2, 1, 2. That is the first row, second column, then first to third column. So this is one thing done. Then this is one act, like one step done. Now you again have your will, whatever direction you want. Let's say I want to go in the down direction. So you go here. And then when you go down, whatever cell you land upon, you have to take that arrow. So this arrow is to the right. So you will land here and you got the answer. So you land upon here. And that is how you will return true that yes, that is possible to go to the second row, last column. Okay, 2, 1. Now how you can check that out? What you can see here is that because you only have a very finite amount of, you can say, you can, like, you should not go back. That is the only thing. You should not go back. You should always go in the forward direction. And let's say that you are somehow moving along the grid. Okay, let's say moving along the grid, and then the grid is saying you to go somewhere down, and let's say you go down and then it trying to send you back. That is a false thing. You should not go back, because if you somehow land upon the same, let's say you are traversing along like this, you land upon the same let's say cell, then that is bad, because if you land on same cell, this will try to send you an infinite circle, or that is a bad thing. So what's the best thing possible? That from every, you have two actions. Okay, from the first position you always have four choices. You can either go top, bottom, left, or right. So for every position, you will first, because this is like a graph traversal, you can just also assume that this is some sort of a graph, like okay, you start from this particular point in a grid, and then you're doing some sort of a DFS. In a DIV first search, you try to go in all the directions. You're doing a recursive call in all the directions, given the condition that it should not go out of bound. If you're going out of bound, you just pause. And if you land upon a block that you are already traversed, let's say you go from here, you go to this, then you try to come back. You go from one block to the next block. That is fine. And then you want to try to come back. that is a bad thing because you are already flown through that path. So the negative conditions are that you should not go out of bound. Also, you should not travel upon the same path that you have already traveled. Okay. And you have two actions in a conjugative step. You have to first choose whatever direction you want to go, and then whatever cell you land upon, you have to go there. So you have two steps as well, like two actions. So that is the only thing that you actually have to do. You have to start from the very first cell. You will do a DFS by doing a recursive call in all the four directions. That is taken as step one. Then whatever cell that you land upon after doing that particular thing, whatever, then in the next step, you will take whatever arrow that you have and take that as the base and go to the left or right depending upon the cell that you land upon. In all of these steps, if you go out of bound or land upon the same cell that you have already traversed, just return false. And whenever you're trying to do all of this stuff, if you somehow reach the very end, the 2, n cell, then that is the wonderful part that yes, you have got to the very end, you have somehow found out the answer, return yes. Or else if you find out all the other possible thing because you're doing a DFS, you'll try to find all the possible combinations because it only has two rows and O, like you can do at most of O of n traversal. Like you can go from one to the left to the right. Even if you like try to do a conjugative type of thing, it can be maximum of 2 of n. You cannot traverse more than 2 of n because you cannot re-traverse the same block. You are taking some visited vector. Okay, you can take some visited vector or like a matrix that will tell you that you have already traversed that block or block again and again. If you have already traversed, you should not travel it because you have already traveled it. That is bad. So that is, man, you can do an at most traverse of O of n, O of 2 of n, which is like a reasonable time complexity you can take. Which means that you can just do a simple DFS over this whole grid, starting from the very start to the very end. If you re-traverse a block, like you just said, like negate that condition. If you go out of the bound, negate the condition, you will traverse in the first step by your means, go left, right, top, bottom. And then the next step, whatever cell you land upon, take that decision and try to reach the very end. If you somehow reach the very end, it is very fine. Else you just return false. That's the complete thing that you have to do. I'll go to the code part. That will make you more sense. But that's the complete thing that you actually have to do. I've written some comments as well, so that it will become easy. So what we have done is that we have taken the first input and the array, that is the directions array, like the arrow array, that is also taken as a string, like these two strings as well, that is taken as well. So now we have taken the input. Now if you take and make a visited matrix as well of 2, n, that is so that you understand that we should not retraverse a particular block or cells. Now we will call this check function that will check that we will start from 0, 0, that is numbered from 1, 1, but it's better that we start from 0, 0. All the things are indexed from 0, 0. We just, our main overall goal is to start from the very top left to going to the very right bottom. Okay, so we just have to ensure that we start from 0, 0. We are sending out the array that we have the directions, the visited, you can say, matrix, and this is one more thing. That is zero. This is the action. By action, I mean that you actually have two steps. The first step is to choose whatever direction you want. And the next step is whatever cell you land upon, take that. So you have two things that you actually have to do in the recursion. So yeah, this is will actually help us to tell us what is the actual step that we are on. If this returns that somehow we have reached the very end, the bottom right, then we turn this, else return two. Let's check what this check function is doing. This is just a recursive function, which is just doing DFS. Okay, now this is the inputs. So if it's a recursive function, so we have to have first the base condition. The base condition is that if we somehow reach the very end, that is x equal to 1 and y, like which is the second row and the last column, we somehow reach that, return true, that we have somehow got to the very end. If we go out of bound, return false. If we retraverse on the same visited block, then return false. Now if we don't have, If we have not already traversed upon that, if you have not gone out of bound, which means that we are still in the matrix, we have to still go to the right side and try to find some answer. So, which means that we are on some block that is still not traversed. So we have to first mark it as traversed. So we'll first mark it as traversed. And then actually start our recursive part on the DFS. Now, we have to start a recursive part on the DFS, but we have to ensure that what step that we are on the recursion, which means that either we have the choice to do and go in all the directions, or it's the chance of whatever block I land upon. So it checks, like it depends upon the action that we have. Okay, if it is zero, which means that we are just on the very first part, very first step, then which means that I can take the action. So which I can take the action, which means that I can go in all the other directions. Okay, you can say left, right, top, bottom, all directions. And then because that is the thing, and if any of these directions somehow lead to a good answer means that I somehow get a true in any of the directions which I somehow go. So if any of them returns true, which means that I have to do an OR of all of these conditions, which means that I somehow go in all the four directions, top, bottom, left, right, which somehow I go out of bound, then all of these conditions will tackle them. We should not you can say go in all the directions. Somehow the directions which are valid only will traverse over them. And if any one of them returns true, then which means that we somehow got an answer. So we will take them. So we have to take an OR of that. And we'll go in all the directions. And now because we have done one of our steps, that is done a move by our choice, then we have to do a choice by whatever cell we land upon. So we'll make this as one, which means that now we have done our action by ourselves. The next iteration, whenever this function is called again, because we are doing the check function again, this check function will be called, but now with the action of one. When one action means that now we have done our part, now we will move depending on the cell that we land upon. So if this is action equal to zero, then only we have our choice, that it will first get to our choice. Then we'll mark it as one, which means that now we have to do and depending upon the arrow that we land upon. Now whatever arrow that we land upon, if it is a right, we will go to right. If it is a left, we go to a left, because it is either left or right. So now as you can see, if it We are only finding out OR upon all the conditions, and then if we find out left or right, we'll go and finding out left and right. And now when we go left and right, we have to now make it as zero again, because now we have done the movement depending upon the block that we'll end upon. Now we have to do the movement again by our choice. So that is the overall thing that we have to again do and again. In the end, if any of them returns true, which means that somehow we somehow reach to the very end, this condition met, this will return true, and all of these OR conditions will somehow pick that true and return the answer. Okay, that's a complete logic. You can read about this code. I will put that in the comment box of this particular code as well. That's a complete logical code part for this particular problem. If you still have any doubts, you can mention in the comment box for this particular video. I will be bringing out more and more videos. So if you have any doubts, you can mention it on the comment box. Thank you for watching this video till the end. I will see you next one. Good coding, and bye.